was a single mother. She was abandoned by the family she belonged to. And there in the wilderness with her son, alone, with very little provision, she was wondering. She was questioning. Does anyone care? She's crying in the desert. She's lost in her despair. She thinks nobody loves her. Hagar thinks nobody's there. But God says, I will be a ring of fire around her, and I will be the glory in her midst, and the power of my presence will bring her to her knees, and I will lift her up again, for I'm the God who sees. I'm the God who sees. Then he speaks in gentle whispers, and he softly calls her name. She feels his arms enfold her as he holds her, and she'll never be the same. 'Cause I'm the God who never changes, and my promises are true. And when this world deserts you, this is what I'll do. And then there was another woman named Ruth. She was from the land of Moab, and she was met with grief and heartache. She was a widow, and she lived with her mother-in-law, who was also a widow. And now it was time to move on. But Ruth had never been to Bethlehem. She had never tasted of the house of bread. But now she had heard an inner invitation to come and taste and see. And so she vowed herself to her mother-in-law and said, where you go, I will go. Where you lie, I will lie. Where you die, I will die. And she begins a journey to the promised land. She's traveling through the desert, and she's leaving her despair. She's hoping for a future, praying God will lead her there. And he says, I will put a ring around your finger, and I will bless a child within your womb, and the Savior will be born through you to free the world from sin. And he'll make all things new for you and love you back to life again, again. And then from Ruth, who gave birth to a son, Obed, who gave birth to a son, Jesse, who gave birth to a son named David. Now this same once shepherd boy, mighty warrior, anointed king, is alone, terrified, in the darkness. He's hiding in the desert. he's battling despair. David thinks his life is over, it's over, and God, he doesn't care. But God says, in the hour of your deepest need, you'll find that I am near. I am here. And I will be a ring of fire around you, and I will be the glory in your midst, and the power of my presence will again, for I'm the God who sees. And then, from the line of David, finally, Jesus, the Messiah, the Anointed One, Yeshua, the Christ, born in the same house of bread to be the bread of life in the town of Bethlehem. And he would grow, and he would be called the Son of God. He would be called Emmanuel, God with us. And he would heal, and he would reveal. And then he had an encounter with a woman named Mary of Magdala, who was plagued by demons, tormented by evil spirits. And Jesus set her free. And Mary followed him. She listened at his feet. She served him, and she loved him. Oh, how she loved him. But then she watched as they nailed him to the cross, and as they placed his body in the tomb. In that moment, her hope died. She's crying in the garden. She's broken in despair.